Hi everyone, in this video I will show you how to use building shapefiles in Mac21FM. In Mac 2020 Update 1, we developed a new feature that makes it easy for flood modelers to use building shapefiles directly into their 2D models. In this simple example, we have a river crossing an urban area. The river goes across the domain from west to east and is represented by quadrangular elements. The floodplain is made of triangles, as you can see. For our area of interest, we made a building footprint feature class. Buildings are colored according to their height. On the right bank, we have a small building colored in blue located in a depression. You can see it here. Its height was set to 1 meter, so we'll be able to see how it gets submerged during the simulation. In this example, we will simulate both pluvial and riverine flooding. Now, if we zoom in a little bit, we'll be able to investigate the buildings and the mesh. You should notice that the building footprint polygons are not directly digitalized in the mesh. However, for this feature to work, the resolution of the mesh must be consistent with the resolution of the building polygons. The engine will decide which elements are within a building polygon and which elements are not, and will treat those elements accordingly. Now, if we zoom out a little bit, we will be able to see the other information we have on the buildings, which is the roof type. We have two types of roofs, and this will be used in the model configuration. We have the black buildings that are normal, and we have two green buildings here that are actually made of grass. Now we will look into Mac21FM and see how this was implemented. In the domain, we can see that the mesh was imported as is and the buildings are not embedded. Now, if we go to the new infrastructure tab, we will be able to define the input shapefile. To do so, we must tick include building zones. Then we need to define that we want to work with a shapefile. And we will tell Mac21FM that the elevation of the buildings come from an attribute from the file. And in that case, we work with height and not with levels. So you have to point to the building shapefile you have. You will be asked to specify the code. The code is a unique identifier for the different type of buildings. As we saw earlier, we have normal and grass roofs, and you have to define which attribute holds the elevation, which in that case is height. The first attribute should be an integer, and the second one should be a number. Now we cancel. We can see that the two zones are being recognized. Okay. In this example, we will tick include so that the buildings will be simulated in with the engine. And later we will see what happens if we untick those tick boxes. Now let's look at the bed resistance tab. We can see that the two types of buildings that we specified are now listed here, and we can define a roughness for each of those types. So let's pick 60 for the normal buildings and 32 for the buildings that have a grass roof. We also need to configure the infrastructure tab. Okay. In this tab, we will configure the different flow parameters. A building face is defined as a face in the mesh where the element on one side of the face belongs to a building zone and the element on the other side does not belong to a building. If the water level on both sides is above the building level, the flow equation is applied normally. Otherwise, an empirical formula is used. This Wi equation requires a coefficient which can be entered here. The critical water level difference defines the water level below which the discharge gradient is suppressed, and that is used for stability purposes. As you can see here, for each building zone, you can de-specify a runoff factor. That factor should be between 0 and 1. The runoff factor is multiplied to the flux across a building face and can, for example, represent the percentage of the water collected from the roof that does not flow over the surrounding ground. And this is all you need to configure in Mach21FM to represent the buildings in your area of interest. Now we will switch to the results after running the simulation so we can see how the engine interprets those different parameters. I have loaded the building shapefile for visualization purposes. You can see here that at the beginning of the simulation, the water is flowing normally in the river. On the floodplain, all the elements are dry. Now let's start the animation. You can see that at this point in time, the floodplain elements are also activated. The buildings are receiving rain, and as we saw earlier, a Wi equation is applied to transfer the water from the roof to the surrounding ground. Now let's go further in the simulation. The river is now overtopping, and we can see that the engine has nicely represented the flow in between the buildings. The depression here will keep filling up until we get to the point where the building we discussed earlier is being submerged. At this point in time, the flow equation is resolved normally for those elements. If we plot a time series on one of those elements, we will see the building being overtopped. We can see that at this point in time, the rain starts to fall, and at this point in time, the building starts to be submerged until the flood recedes. Now, let's look at the roughness values that were used by the engine during the simulation. As you can see, we have the three areas that we specified as inputs to the model. We have the normal floodplain, we have the normal buildings, and we have the two buildings for which the roughness was 32. Now, let's assume that we do not expect the buildings to be overtop, and the rain falling on the roof will be entirely collected. We have made a second example, which differs from the first one only by unticking the checkboxes for the different building zones. This will mean that the shallow water equation will not be resolved for those elements, and the water on the roof will not be transferred to the neighboring cells. Let's have a look at the bed resistance panel. As you can see, it is not possible to specify the roughness anymore for those buildings because the flow equation will not be enabled. Now, let's go to the infrastructure tab. The same is true with the runoff factor because none of the flow will be transferred to the surrounding elements. Let's have a look at the result of such a simulation. Looking at the beginning of the simulation, we can see that when the rain event starts, the building elements are not dry. This is for water balance purposes. The volume falling on the buildings is recorded, but this water is not contributing to the flooding of the surrounding areas. Now, if we look at what is happening to the small building we discussed earlier, we can see that it is not being overtopped anymore. This concludes this video on the modelization of buildings in Mach 21 FM. Thanks for watching and bye bye.